Hi there, welcome back to my Hackerrank series. Like before, I have my Hackerrank webpage on the left, and I've got a little Jupyter notebook on the right that will help me to explain what I'm actually doing. The next challenge is called Nested Lists. It's an easy one. Well, it is categorized as easy for Hackerrank, but it's a bit of a fiddly one, and you can see that the success rate is 91.47%, so almost 9% of people cannot really do that. But I'll run you through every little detail that you need to solve and also understand the bigger issue. How do we tackle these kind of problems in Hackerrank? So stay tuned. If you're enjoying this, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. So let's go ahead. Let's hit solve challenge. Like before, I have always emphasized how important it is to read the question. But if you remember, this question was called nested lists. So what are nested lists? Really quickly, on my Jupyter notebook on the right, I will give, for example, my list equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is a normal list where you can say, okay, give me the number that sits at index 0. 1 sits at index 0 because in Python, we start counting from 0. So this is index 0, index 1, index 2, index 3, and index 4. This is just a normal list. This is not a nested list. But if I would say my nested list, it would be a list of lists. You have a bigger list, and then you have lists within the bigger list. For example, I have got 3 in it. So I will say this one has 1 and 2. This one has A and B and C. And this one has got Sam and 25. This is your nested list. So remember that, like before, if I tell you the indexes, you will see that this first list is index 0. This second list is index 1. If I were to run that, if I say my nested list in index 1, I am expecting to print A, B, C all together. Look at that. Brilliant. So this is a list inside a bigger list. So now you may ask, how can I access only character B? Well, you know how to access A, B, C altogether. And now B character sits at index 0 and 1. So if I go 1 and 1, I can easily access that letter B. So really quickly, this is what a nested list is. Feel free to start coding in your own Jupyter notebook. Okay, I'll get rid of these, clear the screen. All right, let's go back to the task, read it really carefully, and get this done. Given the names and grades for each student in a class of n students, we will have number of n students, and each of them will have their name and how much they scored in, for example, mathematics. Store them in a nested list. For example, the nested list will look like this. I have Sam, who scored 4 out of 5. Then I have Bill, who scored 3 out of 5, and all of that has to be inside a bigger list. So that's my nested list. I'm sure you understand what I'm talking about now. I want to, maybe I'm not gonna delete that, I'll keep it here so you can think about it. So we want to make a nested list that stores people's names and their scores in a nested list and print the names of any students having the second lowest grade. So if I had a third person and their name was Jess, and they scored 2. So what I need to print is the word Bill because they have the second lowest score. This is the lowest, which is 2. This is the second lowest, means from the end. If there are multiple students with the second lowest grade, order their names alphabetically. For example, if I have another student called Taylor who also scored 3, now I have Bill who scored 3 and Taylor who scored 3, I will first print Bill because A, B, B is first, and then T for Taylor. So I will print Bill and then Taylor in alphabetical order. For example, if you receive Chai, who scored 20, Beta scored 50, and Alpha scored 50, the ordered list of score is 20 and 50. So the second lowest score is 50. There are 2 students with that score, Beta and Alpha. Ordered alphabetically, the names are printed as first Alpha, and then Beta. This is a multi-layered challenge, but I'll make it really easy for you to understand. Let's look at our coding area in Hackerrank. If you haven't seen my previous videos, I call this part the execution part. So this is actually where you get stuff done. So let's move it down. Up here is where you prepare, oops, not like that. I don't want it in a list. Prepare your tools per se. So I'm gonna make a function. I'm gonna call it sort students. This is a function that I wanna call. And I will come back and I will decide what to receive from the user. But for now, I'll put the word pass here because I wanna study my execution part. Imagine the analogy I normally give is that, for example, you go and buy from a supermarket, you buy everything that you wanna make a pizza, but you haven't still made the pizza. It's in the execution part that you say, okay, now mix this with that and put it in the oven and it will be a pizza. So that is gonna be happening here. So if you don't do your execution correctly, your pizza is never gonna be ready. Let's look at the execution part. There is a loop. Inside the loop, you are asking the user, how many students do you have? That comes from this input variable here. So you probably will say, I have 5 students. Then this will be 5 as an example, but it's not 5. I will let the user decide how many students they have. Once they do that, this loop runs that many times. If you have 20 students, this will run 20 times. If you've got 100, it will run 100 times. But every round that it runs, we get their name and we get their score. You may ask, I need to store them in a nested list because that's what the question was asking me. I have to put it in a nested list with people. Hey, this is Sam who scored 5. This is Bill who scored 20 and so forth. If you want to do that, you will need an empty list so that you can start making a nested list out of that. So I will call scores. Maybe let's call it names and scores. Let's call it like this. So this is an empty container for me. I have prepared an empty list, which every time I will get someone's name and their score and put it in my container. Then go back up again, get a name, get a score, put it in there. How do I do that? Very simple, using the append method. So call your container. What is my container called? Names, scores. That's the name of the container. And every time this loop runs, so now I have someone's name, which is, for example, Bill, their score is 5. I'm going to put it in a new list with name and score and append it to my container. For example, imagine a student number 1 is Sam and their score is 5. What happens? I say, this is Sam. This is 5. Now let's put it in a list. So it will look like this. So I have Sam and 5. So this is equivalent to that. And now I'm saying, put it inside names and scores. So the bigger list will look like this. Now I have only 1 student, names, scores. The next round when it runs, I have another student that is, for example, Bill. And they scored 4. When I run this line, it will add it to the end. It will be Bill and 4. So this is what is happening. And I was kind of making sure this happens here because when it comes up here, I want to send names and scores into my function. I want to say, okay, I'm going to give you a list, a big list of 100 people. You go ahead, sort them, and tell me who got the second lowest grade. But make sure once we are done with our tools, we have to use them. Because so far, I have made a big list full of things. I will prepare some tools to work with that, but I actually need to use your tools. I will have to use my tools. I'm writing it here so that I will not forget. Okay, let's move it down. Let's add another student. Let's add Jess. Jess scored 2. How can I sort these nested lists based on the score? If you remember a couple of minutes ago, I told you I can access these numbers by just saying, for example, if I were to understand what was Bill's score, I can say, okay, go to names and scores. Bill sits at, this is index 0, this is index 1. So Bill sits at index 1. So this is Bill's information. His score sits at index 1 again because his name is index 0, this is index 1. So if I do that, I can access Bill's scores. So I can simply write a for loop and say for student in names underscore scores, print student. You can see that I can print every student one by one, but I don't want to print the student's name. I want to print the student's score. So this is index 0, this is index 1. Let's put index 1 here. Ta-da! I can easily print students' scores without their names. So I don't really care about their names. That's brilliant. That's easy. Now, all I need to do is put their scores in a container. So I can just say scores is an empty container. Every time you take someone's score, append it to my empty container. I know that someone's score sits at student index 1. I just showed it to you right here. So let's get rid of that and just print my scores. How about this? Look at that. I made a list that takes people's names and scores, gets rid of their names, and only keeps their scores. This is awesome. So if I had even more students, let me just make this bigger. I'm gonna add a list, call it Bill, who scored 2. I wanna make sure I'm gonna challenge myself with everything. There is Taylor, who scored 4. And there is probably another Sam. I wanna even have a duplicate of Sam's here. So run that, get rid of that. Look at that. I have a list of all my student scores. This is where I am storing my scores. Can I simply sort it? If I say sorted, which is a function in Python, you will see that this will get sorted. Look at that. Now, instead of having 5, 4, 2, 2, 4, 3, I have 2, 2, 3, 4, 4, and 5. You might be easily saying now, okay, now I know the second lowest score is 3. Let me add one more person with score 3 because I want to make 2 people so that I can sort their scores with their names as well. So I have Jill. I have Jill who also scored 3. Let's run that again. All right, I have 2 threes here. So ideally, I should be printing Jill first and Sam next. How do I do that? Once I have stored scores in a list and I have sorted them, I want to make sure I don't have repetitions because then it will be difficult for me. I don't know how many people scored 2 so that I can get rid of them and I can come to the people who scored 3. So how can I get rid of these 2, 2 and make it just 1, 2? 1, 3, 1, 4, and 1, 5. It will come in really handy, trust me. If I go and say, I want you to give me the sorted set of scores. That is the property of set. Set gets rid of duplicates. It's very, very handy. Now, I'm gonna make a new variable and call it sorted scores is this one. So I have sorted scores. Look at that. I don't have any duplicates. You might say, well, we lost some people's scores. I understand. Don't worry. We still have their names and scores. We can always find them. I'm just trying to make my life easier. I will copy this, put it down here. Okay. So now I have a good flow of whatever I have done. So after I sort people's scores, let me get rid of that as well. It's very easy for me now to find the person or people who scored second lowest. Is anyone who scored 3? So I'm gonna say second lowest will be sorted scores index 1 because index 0 will be the lowest, index 1 will be the second lowest. So let's copy that as well, put it here. I'm just putting everything under a nice streamline. Then I can see that second lowest is 3. Brilliant. Now I have second lowest person as well. The last part for me will be like, okay, I know what is the second lowest score. It is 3. Go ahead, find all the students that scored 3. So visually, what human brain does says, okay, look at those numbers. Oh, that's these 2 people. But how can I get Python to do it? That's easy. I will say, again, for student in my original list, which is names and scores, see what it does. You must have an idea what I'm doing now. I want to say, if you see that the student's score is 3, record their name. Don't let their name go. Record their name. So let's make a new container. I want to record their names. Names second lowest. That's an empty container. I'm taking their names. And I'm going to say, if student index 1, because the name is index 0, this is index 1. If index 1 equals this score, which is 3. If you see that the score is 3, what I want you to do is to append their name. Where is their name? In index 0. Student index 0 onto that list. Isn't it smart? And at the end, print names second lowest. Look at that. I got Sam and Jill. Ta-da! It was very easy, wasn't it? But there was one last requirement. They said if there are multiple students with the second lowest grade, order their names alphabetically. That shouldn't be really difficult. I can simply say add a sorted variable here. Look, I just swapped them. It's first Jill, then Sam. Okay, let's just store those in a, I'm gonna store it in the same variable. I stored it here. I just sorted and stored in the same place because that doesn't really matter. And all I need to do now is just print for a name in this list, which is this list that I just sorted, print name. Ta-da! I am very ready to copy everything onto my Hackerrank. What I need to do is just take my scores. Remember I had the word pass? Now I can easily put everything I need. I just need to move these one tab forward. I'm gonna get the names and scores. That's pretty much what I called it here. Once I do that, I append the scores onto this list. Then I sort them and then I find the second lowest, which is great. Let me copy the rest and these need to be tabbed. Yeah, sometimes when you copy, you need to tab not the first line, but the rest of them. So then you do this and then you sort their names and all you need to do is print them. And this one needs to be tabbed. I think my pizza ingredients are ready. Let's just make sure we don't forget to use our tool. What is the tool's name? It's called Sort Students. So put it here and say, I want you to use this tool. And what am I giving you? I'm giving you these ingredients. So go ahead and run the code. Let's see. Oh, it worked on the first sample test case, but we won't know until we submit it finally. Let's submit the final one. All these test cases must be green. Great. Thanks very much, guys. If you liked it, subscribe to my channel, hit the like button. I'm spending a lot of time preparing these, so that would be a really nice gesture from you. Thanks a lot. Stay tuned and see ya.